Rolling.
Audio, video land. What's up, man? The Josh Adams Podcast, the last one of the year. My bad. Let me give it the real bill. The last one of the year. This is the 363rd day, I believe. Khary Fraser in the building again.
What up, what up, what up?
We here celebrating life, liberty, and the pursuit of justice. You know, we here. This been a very tumultuous year. I don't know how we ended the year last year. I don't know what was said. I don't know how we did the last one. Khary might remember, but I don't know. We might have. What did we do? Just like a clip show, or did we actually show up?
I'll tell you exactly what we did. Let me go through.
Well, while he finds that, I don't remember what it is and how we closed it out. I just remember I popped the year off with a very wild ass live video that me and the Motown Lav Kings did that has been taken down.
Okay. It is the last episode of last year was December 20th. And it was Steve Harvey a simp for letting Lori take his name.
Wow, I do remember that podcast. I don't think that wasn't the official last one. That's the one we did, and we thought we were gonna do another one, but we really went in depth about the fact that we didn't think he should have took that. You know, we didn't really get it in. This is an official wrap up, but shout out to Lori Harvey. Since then, her life has changed immensely. Steve Harvey made way more money than he's ever made before. So shout out to the big homie. I look forward to meeting you and kicking it with you. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Naturally, I ain't gonna just walk up on you like that. We already know how I get on. Mm-hmm. But how you feeling, Khary? You good?
Yeah, man, everything good. We got some interesting categories for this award show. This is the first Josh Adams Podcast award show. In some of these categories, I'm gonna just throw at you. So
we ain't gonna do it now, right?
No.
Oh, well, yeah. Right now, okay, I'm gonna say, don't throw it out there now. We ain't gonna give up too much right now. First of all, we just want to start off. EJ not gonna be here today. Mm-hmm. He got some stuff going on. We'll get with him when he come back next week, man. You know what I'm saying? So EJ, very vital and important part of this podcast, and he came out of nowhere, man. So I appreciate him for coming through on the come through side of it all. Before we jump into all that stuff, man, let's get into what we got going on. Khary, you got anything you want to promote before the year is out?
Man, same old, same old. Detroit is different. We building what we doing here. As we see, we get more organized. The video kind of came in the, I guess, like the fourth quarter, kind of like it kind of came in towards the end, and we're going to have more segments, more everything. EJ is helping this build and develop big time.
For sure.
Thank you.
And we've added people to the roster. Like, tell them, like, how we growing as a platform.
Yeah. As a platform, definitely in the comedy world. So T-Barb is here now. Zai, who was a guest on the last crazy ass episode, she's going to be here. Piper's back in full effect. Titties and Tacos.
Shout out to Tacos.
Been talking about what they're gonna do this season, which they have some very interesting creative things going. If you ain't checked out that podcast, definitely. If you like this, you probably need to check out Titties and Tacos.
Get the back order. Go listen to the catalog. It's sensational, man. They are. Titties and Tacos know what they're doing, man. They tried to, they almost tore us down with a little Me Too movement, but we fought through that. We bigger than that. We're a family over here. Sometimes you try to fuck your cousins every once in a while. There's nothing wrong with that. Shout out to Joe. We love him.
Not at all. Joe was, we love Joe, but Joe was definitely.
We should tag that episode in here when they talked about it and we did it so people can go back and do the research, because it's deeper than rap over here, man. Our catalog is deeper than you want to believe. Hold on. Nicholas Devine said, what up, Josh? Board games is looking strong. Oh, beer game, he probably said. Beer game is looking strong, and the jokes flow. Appreciate it, man. Appreciate it, Nick. You know what I'm saying? And the beard is sensational. It's just all natural here, man. It's all natural here, what I got going on. Shea butter and some other things here. No vagina has been added to this. And
what the hell did that got it?
Vagina helps your beard. You know what I'm saying? Do what it's supposed to do from what I heard. And I haven't ate no pussy in a while. And I was talking to Khary about that. Like, man, if you had to, and I mean, for the people out there, just think about this, and I'm gonna pose this question. If the last person you had sex with is the one you're gonna close the year out with, would you be proud of that? If not, should you run out and go fuck something immediately before the year is over with? Hilarious.
I mean, you're making it seem like my grandma with black eyed peas at the end of the year or some shit like that. I don't necessarily think that your sexual partner is like basically gonna set the tone of what's going to carry on into the new year.
Have you ever tried it though? That's my thing, nigga. Like, now that I made you aware of it, Khary, are you going to try to make sure, like, damn, did my year flop last year because of this raggedy bitch that I that I let have me before the year ended. So I mean, just think about that. If the last person you had sex with, could you see yourself spending the rest of your life with? Make sure the person that you fuck is of quality, and that somebody you can be like, well, if I end up getting them pregnant or getting pregnant bad, I wouldn't mind being with them. Even if you don't think about it, like even if you don't want to, just make sure it's somebody of quality. And I mean, you know, mm-hmm. I'm single again. I'm back out here in this way, and I'm gonna stay that way. 2022, it's gonna be a more celibate and disciplined Joshua Adams. And don't call me Josh no more. My name is Joshua.
So why you making the switch to Joshua?
Because I'm a whole new man now, dog, coming into the new year. Everything is different about me, man. If you call me Josh, I will not answer. The podcast is with his name. We can't change that now. But when you see me, hey, what's up, Joshua? Or Mr. Adams. Don't call me Josh, bro. You're likely to get swung on. Real talk. But I got some stuff coming up. Let's mm-hmm. see here. I just found out Roxy Reynolds got a page on Instagram. She's changed her life around. It's nothing too salacious. She's married now. Hey, if you out there and you want to follow Roxy Reynolds, if you remember who Roxy Reynolds is.
Okay, Roxy Reynolds is an adult star.
A legend in the film, adult film
game. Ebony adult star.
Bro, she's just an adult film star. Stop putting categories and boxes on our people. The woman right here, y'all go follow her, man. She married now. She's a promoter, a producer, an entrepreneur. And she is literally like the Cicely Tyson of the adult film industry.
Cicely Tyson.
You go support that queen. She's changed her life around. And if you've seen her, she really put on good performances. She still look good. But let me follow her, though. Start my year off like that, supporting somebody. She got 821,000 people following her. Okay, here. Let's get to some stuff here. I want to promote where I'm going to be at. Mm-hmm. The last show of the year for me is looking like it's going to be at the Ann Arbor Showcase out in Ann Arbor. Mm-hmm. 7:30 is tomorrow. I know that's a little short notice, but if you ain't got nothing popping, my daughter is calling me. If you ain't got nothing popping tomorrow, man, please pop up, come through, see some comedy before it's all said and done for the year's out. That will be my last show. I got a show on New Year's Eve, but that's probably like a private party. But this is here, it's for everybody. 7:30 Ann Arbor Showcase. Come holler at your boy. And I'm popping the year off. 2022, you can catch me at the MRCC doing the food jokes and comedy show. It's food and jokes. It's thrown by my guy Bo and Zoe. That's going down. That's on January the 7th. It's me, Horace HB Sanders, Bobo Lamb, and Rodney Perry. You know, so if you're familiar with Rodney Perry, he was on the Monique Show. He was in a lot of Tyler Perry films, OG in the comedy game. He actually was a guest on this podcast during the pandemic. He came on. So shout out to the OG for coming and showing a young unknown nigga some love. Mm-hmm. And January the 8th, I'm at the State Theater. Comedy show put together by a lot of scammers and drug dealers. Shout out to my dog, Mr. Northwest 87. It's me, Jay Will, Tattoo Man Page, T Barb, my label mate. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. If this Death Row, I would be who? And then she would be, who would she be? Lady of Rage?
So I think if this was the row, because she coming in after, you'd be like Snoop. And mm-hmm. she'd be like, Michelle.
Who would she be?
I don't know.
You want to make her pop? Like, all right, then we're gonna make her pop.
No, I was gonna say, okay. I mean, it wasn't that many women on Death Row, so I guess like Rage. Yeah,
all right, then. Well, me and the Lady of Rage of Detroit is different. After Dark, we'll be at the State Theater. Like I said, you heard the lineup, it's gonna be crazy. Tap in, get in. Where the fuck you fit in at? So that's what we had to promote there. And now we can get into our year in review, man. We already talked about the growth of the podcast and the network. You see, we stepped our shit up here. Look at this. This wasn't here at the beginning of the year, y'all.
No.
This is $40,000 we paid for this. That's $40,000. That's $40,000 right there that we just paid for that right there. So that shows y'all that the money y'all been giving and supporting us with, thank y'all. You know what I'm saying? Big time. You want to sponsor some? Do it here. It can be right here on this $40,000 thing that we just do this. Look at this. It's like a mini Soul Train Board award. Like on the Soul Train Board, like when they be doing the names, they be like, hold on, what is this? They be like, Rakim. And they do shit like that.
Okay.
Growth of the podcast.
You got a shout out.
What we got? Nick. What'd he say?
Nick is saying, I'll pray for a queen to fall onto you at the New Year's Eve party, and you can just start 2022 with a new smash.
Nicholas, I appreciate that because you feel like you helped me out. But what I'm going to do is rebuke that because I'm going in celibate, man. Pussy ain't did nothing but ruin everything that I ever had built and that I thought was pure. Pussy is the evilest thing on earth. It's not money. Pussy is the root of all evil. So, yeah. So, no vagina for me all 2022. I gave up pork 4 years ago. I'm giving up pussy as of 2022. So I appreciate it. Hopefully I meet a woman that I can build with on some business type stuff and maybe form a real friendship and build a foundation from there. And then we can take it from that point on wherever we decide to go. But and I'm stepping outside of my race when it comes to dating as well. I know I've said that several times, hilarious, but I'm dipping my toe into the game of white Asian. And what else is out there for me? White Asian and Chaldean.
Well, I gotta. Well, that means I'm gonna pick the song of the day today, and then I'm gonna have you break the lyrics down on that same.
Shout out to Khary. So he gonna have a song of the year. We go. That's gonna be the song of the year.
Okay.
All right. So let's get into some stuff on the news. Tip of the game here. Khary been bringing this up back and forth, and mm-hmm. people have a problem with it. And this has been one of the biggest stories of the year. Kanye West is our man of the year. I know they want to give it to Elon Musk, but Kanye West has had a very tumultuous year.
Yeah,
in the news. Like, I mean, he's become a billionaire. He's probably been a billionaire, but mm-hmm. he's been a billionaire. His shoes. Mm-hmm. He's dropped an album, and he's changed it several times, and he's done something I've never seen before: a live concert. Listening party mm-hmm. at a stadium, and troubles with his wife, and mm-hmm. he's I mean, put it like this. He's our simp of the year. Can we do that?
Yeah, we can.
Let's give
that.
It up for that. Yeah. Kanye yeah. West is okay. our simp of the year. That's our first award we're giving away today. Is Kanye West is our simp of the year. This is our first one, our inaugural simp of the year. Kanye West has gotten it. His wife has left him. She's divorcing him. And now she's dating a comedian from SNL, Pete Davis. And Kanye has currently made songs and she been at the concert with the babies and freestyle songs and was like, change the mm-hmm. song up, like, come home, please, Kim, I want my family back. He went on the Drink Champs in front of Noriega and EFN and said, listen, I want my family back. And mm-hmm. she don't want it. And he's currently bought a home across the street from where they used to live at, where
yeah.
together.
I mean, where they were. I mean, as the story goes, anything involving the Kardashians, it could all just be clout chasing, but we're gonna go on this being the truth that they are actually going through a divorce and Kanye West has purchased a home across the street to be closer to the family because he wants his family back. And one of the points that I brought out in the text message thread that me, Josh, and EJ share is the whole concept of if Pete Davidson has moved into that house, mm-hmm. as reckless and crazy as they try to make Kanye seem, mm-hmm. how reckless and crazy is that to move this man in that don't really have a relationship with your kids? You mm-hmm. ain't really finalized that divorce. That is some wild shit
that's,
to me.
That's no.
And nobody's really bringing that point up. And that really needs to be brought up because at first, when I thought moving across the street, like, man, that's very aggressive. But then when I think if you're moving another man in the house, that's more aggressive and that's very out of pocket.
I didn't know that she moved him in. I thought that he was just probably over there. I know they've been saying out together. He drove her Bentley around and all of that stuff. But I didn't know that he moved in. Now, Pete Davis, I don't know what he on. As far as, like, you know, you've been dating somebody for a while. It's like, you got your own money and I get it. But, like, who just moves in with somebody off the bail, my dog? Like, so that will make stuff crazy. And I don't feel bad. Like, I mean, like I said, I can relate to Kanye because I am a super simp at heart. That's mm-hmm. why I'm a lot of times I'm in the situations I'm in. Runaway is like a story out of my life. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I've lived that life. I'm an asshole. I've done fucked up shit. But, you know, I love you. But my thing is this. If he want to buy, if he's got the money, if I want to move across the street from my family, I'm going to do that. I'm used to waking up with my daughters in my bed, my son over there, and now they can't. I don't want them to have to drive 15, 20 minutes, even if it's 5. I'm going to be across the street, and they can see me whenever they feel like it. They can cross the street and come holler at their pop. So I don't think that's crazy. But again, Kanye West, our simp of the year, sponsored by Yeezy, which is crazy. I didn't even know that he was a sponsor of this year's simp of the year award. Kanye West got it, man. Congratulations, my brother. Yeah. You took simp into a whole nother level, my brother.
He did, and I do think I feel where you're coming from. it can be aggressive, especially going through a divorce. I think like maybe paying for joint custody, but I don't know. I mean, if he really going through that shit, and I don't necessarily know if Pete Davidson has moved in, but just knowing that he spent a night and drove the car and shit, that's that. And you ain't finalized a divorce and you got kids in the house. I want to say they got like four kids. Yeah, four kids. That's, you can't be having no random goddamn man. That's that. First off, it's Ryan stepping for Pete Davidson.
Oh, for sure.
As a man to do some shit like that,
he can spend a night, he can't move in.
Especially being that Pete Davidson is one of those people that speaks about the mental health. And like, I think people was going in on him over something and he was like, hey man, you know, I need back away from me. It's like, where is your sympathy for another man knowing that he got four kids and she going through a divorce and ain't final? You need to keep this shit real low key. And Pete Davidson is going into like simp of the year. He gonna go into running for sucker of the year because that's some sucker shit to do. You shouldn't be doing no shit like that for anybody.
So he shouldn't what?
Attention.
I mean, I don't think he moved in, but he doing sucker shit because he decided to like spend a night over the chick house. He kicking it.
Yeah,
with?
You can't spend a night over a woman with four kids and she's still
why
going and the divorce ain't finalized. Nah, man.
Why you can't? No, I respect that. Like, put it like this.
You can't do that.
I would never mess with a married woman until it's over with. You don't play with that, no matter how contrived or scripted or that relationship is. Yeah. You wait till it's finalized.
Yeah.
So I see what you're saying. So I guess I can't fight it because I don't agree with him doing that. So I guess he would be able to be running for sucker of the year.
Yeah, I'm not saying he won it, but it definitely puts him in that category.
He's nominated.
Especially being that he's big on the whole mental health thing. Mental health. It'd be different if
and
it's
we know
no
Kanye
offense,
is documented. True.
No offense to Future, but like if it's Future and you assume Future moving, slaying that game, you know what I'm saying? Even with Scottie Pippen wife, but being that Pete Davidson has asked for the general public to empathize with him and not talk shit about him over shit like this, and him being that reckless in a house with four kids, come on, man. You can't be doing no shit like that. That's some sucker shit.
Sucker shit for sure. Sucker shit for sure. So, I don't, but how do you feel about Kanye moving across the street? Like, I mean, like I said, I just gave you the way I feel about that. Like, I don't have a problem with it. He got the money. He want to be close to his family. Do you think he tripping?
I think it can be seen as an aggressive move, especially a black man moving into like, what's that? The Hidden Hills and shit like that.
He was a black
celebrity.
Man who already lived in Hidden Hills.
He was a celebrity, but you still always, you know, OJ Simpson. So, I mean, I look at it like,
and right now we just setting up Kanye West moving across the street from Kim Kardashian. He got he's a simp of the year.
I think it's an aggressive move. I think because the kids and the family and everything, and he wants to still be present.
Mm-hmm.
I understand, but I think it can be seen as aggressive. I saw a lot of women put up posts saying like I was afraid and I had so many stalker vibes, and I saw like I'm probably read like about 7 posts about how just even seeing that story triggered those women to, you know, kind of trigger some of their past trauma from men.
But is that stalking when you buy real estate from across the street? Is one thing if he park his charger outside your house and wait for people to come in and out. This man bought real estate across the street. He's not really stalking, he's a homeowner.
But it's in the same vein because basically now you end up with your car parked outside every day.
Okay, but I'm a homeowner and these are my kids. You know what I'm saying? So it's not the same thing. I love how people attach themselves to what's going on with a celebrity when it's not the same thing at all. It's easy to be triggered, like, you know what I'm saying? And in a new year, can we do a thing here? Can we stop being so triggered by stuff? Can we stop, like, bending things to the point of moving the goalposts so close that it's like, yeah, that's close to me, and I can relate to that. No, you can't relate to that. Yo, unless your stalker bought the apartment across the hall from your apartment, you can't relate to that. That's not stalkerish.
That is.
That's a man who was in love. And he's divorcing his wife and he has kids. You can't relate to that.
Does seem like some shit off of a Lifetime movie, though. Like, you go through the divorce and then you open your apartment door and the dude is across the way like, yeah, I live here. Or like one of the weird Tyler. You ever see that Tyler Perry movie with Jussie Smollett, sister?
No, which one?
And Brandy got HIV and the guy, I don't know, shit.
I know what movie you're talking about, where they got A's at the end and then Lance crosses in there. Anybody who knows the title of that movie, put it in there. But I remember that movie. The barhead dude had a plane and they was flying around, and then she had AIDS, and then Mariah Carey was like a social worker. Mariah Carey was a social worker in Precious. She wasn't in that one.
But she became like a social worker. It's like he opened her up because she Kim Kardashian is in that movie as strange as we talking about it.
I'm about to look that movie up because I know what you're talking about.
I wonder if that house was even...
But who was stalking who? Nobody was stalking nobody in there. Like, she left her husband. Well, was her husband... He was trying to get her back. So that's my thing. Like, y'all ladies say y'all want a man to apply pressure. But then, like, when a man fights for what he want, you want a guy to apply pressure when you still want him.
Yeah, when you want him.
But
yeah.
When it's long over...
We've established this. Whatever a man do when they don't like you, you creepy. Like, just period. If they don't like you, it's creepy. You could say hello, and it's like, ugh, why you say hello like that? I mean, you know, it's just like that. Let's see. Nick guy, I wonder if that house was even for sale, or did he just go there and make an insane offer? Ain't no telling. He may have made that insane offer. You know what I'm saying? For the value, it's like he not buying it for the real estate. He buying it to be closer to his kids.
Yeah, he probably for sure just went over there with a blank check and was like, look, here go Big Sean Masters. I want this house. And they was like, shout out to my guy, famous Frank James. It was called Temptation.
Okay.
Yep. I remember that movie, Temptation. Yep. That's what the movie was called. Because the movie was very scary because she was having sex and she got AIDS. And then, I mean, luckily, she never gave her husband no more of that tainted pussy. And he was good after that. And then I think he moved on and got married. And then, the girl became a social worker, and then that's what it was. Yeah, Tyler Perry movies be dark. Shout out to the big homie Tyler Perry, another billionaire. we got anything else we want to cover in the news? I mean, I think we kind of
into the awards.
Put a bow on that.
You already went into one of the awards, so we can go into the next award.
I mean, we kind of just made that up. Do we want to blow our load this fast, this quick?
Yeah, let's go, because it's enough awards.
Is it?
Yeah, man, I got a lot of categories.
Do they got anything to do with our favorite moments of this shit too? This all tied into that.
We're doing everything go into that.
All right, well, go ahead. I'm gonna let Khary do it. Khary, produce the hell out this show.
So let's see. All right, drum roll. Now with these categories, Josh don't know what these categories are, so I'm gonna just throw some things at him and then see if he can remember. All right, so first,
it's gonna be from the last podcast. That's as far back as I can remember.
Yeah, basically.
So it's gonna be sad.
And I'm gonna throw other stuff he should remember. So, we gonna say Wild Boy of the Year.
We gotta go Wild Boy of the Year.
And let's give the categories, okay? And some of these things will go a couple different times. So Wild Boy stories.
You ain't gotta run it down.
Okay. Oh, you just gonna go off the top.
We'll go off the top.
And then we gonna come up with a joke, and then we'll vote, and then we'll talk consensus.
Yeah, we gonna talk. I mean, we don't do jokes here. Shit, just funny naturally on this show.
All right.
And we gonna make it run like that.
All right.
So Wild Boy of the Year. I mean, I wanted to find a way to put that in there, but it's Paul Pierce.
I'm saying from the show.
From our show, Wild Boy of the Year.
Wild Boy of the Year from the show.
Oh, Wild Boy of the Year from our show. It would have to be and I guess we gotta give people points to be able points of reference. It would be Rap Talk from the first live podcast. The first live podcast that ruined my
the house party.
That's got me single right now.
House Party 1.
Man, it was me. But yeah, Rap Talk came on there. Amazing poet, rapper, also has a podcast that I don't know it, so God forgive me for that. If I find out what it is, I'm going to shout it out next year. He came on, he was in there, and he got warmed up. At first, he was chilling. That drink got in him, and he started working his way to that mic. And he came on there, man. He was just like, man, it was like Steph Curry. He's setting that record for the three-pointer in Madison Square Garden. He came through and he was talking about, yeah, man, I be peeing on these hoes. Like, you know what I'm saying? And he said it like that. I'm not paraphrasing. He said, bro, I be peeing on these hoes. And I was like, what do you mean? And then he just went in depth about him peeing on women.
Okay, so if you're interested in this and you checked it and checked the record of the podcast, this was the podcast for August 7th. And it's titled Sex Under a Semi-Truck. Getting her to swipe it, and the the couple that gets them. That's the name of the podcast. So August 7th, 2021, that is the episode. So yeah, Rap Talk. I also got a couple other ones to throw
jump
at you.
Around. You ain't going to throw that around right there. But shout out to that day. That was day my birthday. That was my 37th birthday. How old am I now? 37. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my 37th birthday. Mm-hmm. And the Josh Adams and Friends weekend was amazing. We did a comedy show. Shout out to everybody that came out and supported that. Shout out to the sponsors, Sweet Tea Leaf. Shout out to Key Sling and Drinks, Kim Math. Shout out to everybody that came out and supported that weekend, from the comedy show to the live podcast to the celebrity to the comedian softball game that we did at Bill Isle. It was big shit. We're gonna do it again next year, and it's only gonna get bigger and better. We're gonna have more fun. So shout out to Rap Talk for being the Wild Boy of the Year, for peeing on women.
Possibly, but we also, you know, gotta put the other one.
No, that nigga got it. That nigga got it. He went crazy.
You think, okay. Because like, if I don't know, the committee gotta throw in, you know, JD's wild ass story.
What JD's story is?
JD's story about the lifestyle.
Oh, his lifestyle.
I mean, JD didn't come in the story of the year.
JD was a part of it. So he might be like best supporting character in the wildest shit that happened on this podcast. Mm-hmm. But that wasn't him. Like, JD just was that was God. Like, JD didn't come as hard. Like, Rap Talk took the game in his hand and went and did everything. If nobody else said nothing that day, Rap Talk made it possible. Was like, dog, he fucked me up. I was captivated the whole time. It was like watching a train wreck. And Rap Talk did his motherfucking thing. JD always come through. He come through and do JD. I wasn't even impressed by what JD did. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like, JD might have tried to do too much, but everything around him carried him. He had a good team, a part of that show that carried JD. JD was a part of a good team. So, you know, shout out to JD and them, like, you know. But no, Rap Talk is like, he's the MVP.
Okay, the MVP of Wild Boy of the Year.
And the Wildest Boy.
You had the Wildest Boy, and then you also had the national perspective from Paul Pierce.
Oh, yeah. Paul Pierce just, that was my scandal of the year. Like, the fact that Joshua Fool, you, I appreciate it. Let me make sure I read that right. Dollar sign Joshua Fool. You. No, that's no, it's not spelled that way. It's Joshua Fool. So it's not really spelled you a fool. It's spelled Joshua, like Joshua Fool, Fool. Yeah, that's how I spell Nick. If I'm not sure if y'all remember, ESPN fired Paul Pierce for playing poker and getting his hair cut and throwing poker chips at strippers. And I don't even know if they strippers. They was girls just shaking their ass. Oh, yeah. My Cash App. Yeah. Shout out to Nick. I guess he's trying to give a nigga a little money. I should have put it up here as opposed to the podcast name. But, yeah, Joshua Fool. So, Joshua Fool.
Yeah, like Joshua.
Yeah, Joshua Fool. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like Joshua in the Bible with a fool at the end of it, with that with the white man's dollar sign in front of it. Now, yeah, scandal of the year, in my opinion. Paul Pierce got fired for just doing what most of the NBA fans do, watching, playing poker, getting their hair cut around a very thick, vivacious woman, shaking that ass meat while he's sitting in the back in the cut, and he's smoking weed. And they fired my baby. And I guess he got some big plan in the future. He was doing a lot of boxing stuff. I seen him doing some analysts for that. But that was my scandal of the year. I mean, I felt that was wrong because – what do you think the people that watch the NBA are doing? Reading the Bible while they watching the NBA? No, they fooling. They smoking weed. They drinking. It might be a stripper around. They having a good time. It's way worse things going on in the world. Do you understand? What do you think Dale Curry doing? What do you think he did after his son set that record? You seen him with them three Chaldean girls? What you think Dale Curry on? NBA? ESPN, you wrong for that. hold on, pause before we move and do anything. I want to show a little love and shout out one of my OGs in the game who just tapped in with the one love, JB, one of my OGs in the game, one of the funniest comedians in the world, in the country, gave me a lot of game, and classic jokes, Skittles to the back of the head, Martin Luther King. Oh, man, getting into a fight. Oh, man, he got some jokes, man. Just want to give a big shout out to my OG, man. Happy New Year's to you, man. We got to get you up here, man. And if I got, I'm going to come pick you up. Fuck that. I ain't waiting on you. I'm going to come pick you up. So shout out to my OG who tapped in with me, man. I love to see that.
All right. So next category, we going to go to Wish she had an OnlyFans of the year. Now, this could be in a national or a local capacity. Wish she had an OnlyFans of the year, as OnlyFans was a hell of a topic, not just on this show.
Because they tried to shut it down. America. Like, this was the year they tried to shut it down and everything.
Yeah. OnlyFans was on the pulse. You know?
The category is what about it?
No. Wish she had an OnlyFans.
Oh, so we wishing if she had
an OnlyFans.
Fans, ooh, who would I wish? Because I have supported, I've supported about two young ladies, OnlyFans. $12.99 is not, that's not too much to ask to see you naked. If I had to think of somebody that I wish had an OnlyFans, who would it be?
Okay, now do you want me to throw out some of the women most talked about on here? So let's go down the list.
Throw some names out there.
Okay, we definitely have you speak a lot of Summer Walker,
the singer.
Yes. Uh-huh. You speak a lot of Ashanti.
Love her music.
The vocalist.
Shout out to Ashanti.
You speak a lot of JT.
JT from the City Girls.
And we also speak a lot of light-skinned Keisha.
Those are four young ladies that I have a great affinity for. Summer Walker is more music than anything. Ashanti, I'm just amazed at how she's evolved and how she's grown and how she's just still at this age of 42 years old or 43 or whatever she is. She's still just scandalous. Like all these years through the Murder, Inc. versus 50 Cent shit, she's still out here unscathed. Nelly did her dirty. And she's still looking amazing. So Ashanti, I wouldn't want her to have OnlyFans. You know what I'm saying? I like how she gracefully just is going throughout life. JT from the City Girls. No problem, JB. No problem. JT, if she had OnlyFans, I mean, JT actually went live and her nipple came out via live. So I seen those titties before. So I would not pay for something I've already seen. And then the last person was light-skinned Keisha.
Yes.
Light-skinned Keisha. If light-skinned Keisha had an OnlyFans, would I want to see it? No, I wouldn't want to see it.
Okay.
If OnlyFans, who would I want to see with an OnlyFans? Somebody out there.
We also had a long Brittany Renner discussion on this podcast.
Shout out to Brittany Renner. No, not her either. Mm-hmm. She don't really hit it. Mm-hmm. It's actually somebody I follow on Instagram, and I don't even want to throw their name out there. It's actually just a regular bitch that I would like to see have OnlyFans, and I'm not even going to put her name out there. But I'm going to just think about it real hard and hopefully let it come out. Hopefully she fall on hard times or decide that she got a little more money that she can make on the side. She know who she is. She know who she is. I would put it on here, but I feel like that would be like...
Yeah, that's putting somebody on blast.
Oh, fuck it.
Creeping.
Let me see this. I feel like I'm cheating y'all by not really giving y'all somebody.
Yeah, you gotta give us somebody.
I feel like I'm cheating y'all by not giving y'all somebody.
It could be a celebrity. So that way the general public knows.
Somebody in the general public that they know. Savannah James.
Oh, here we go.
But I do want to see her cook. All I want to see her is cooking and stuff like that. I would like to see her cook and talk about raising her children. Nothing other than that. Savannah James.
That another controversial the classic, I respect LeBron James so much that I would not even consider anything with Savannah. So definitely that's the OnlyFans. Like even if the OnlyFans rip came to me, I wouldn't even look.
Curry, a goddamn lie.
I would not look. Josh would be like, yo, this shit wild as hell. I'd be like, can't do it, brother. And in reality, can you give that money back?
Curry would beat his dick with the rawest shea butter he could find. If Savannah put up, but I'm not talking none sexual. I just would like to see her on it because people think OnlyFans got to be some sexual shit. It don't. I would just like to see her talk, and she seems like she's a very graceful woman. She carries herself like she's all the confidence in the world. And I would just like to see and hear her talk and do different things. And I'm like something that I can sit down with my daughters and be like, look, this is what you do. This is who I want you to be. Like nothing sexual at all. Shout out to Cardi B for being the creative director over there at Playboy magazine. That's a big deal. I just think that's a power move. I love Cardi B, the way she reinvented herself and went from a stripper to this like icon, bro. Like, I mean, one day we're gonna look back and be like, bro, this was like one of the most amazing transformations we've ever seen. And she still don't see, her nose is getting a little more pointy, and I can tell that they poking around and fucking with that. But outside of that, she the same motherfucker. Shout out to you, Cardi B. We ain't got none but love for you, my baby. None but love. Shout out to you on Offset.
Okay. All right.
And so, they still be acting like they fuck a lot. Like I be seeing them go live and he be like, man, suck my dick on the live, and she be in the bed naked. Like they really sleep in the bed together. Like, I don't think Jay-Z and Beyonce sleep in the bed together a lot.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Yeah, we talked about that. No disrespect. I mean, I shouldn't have to say that, but y'all in the public eye, y'all getting millions of dollars. I should be able to say something about y'all.
All right. So next category, I'm bouncing around. Wildest girl of the year. We can go national and we can go from the podcast.
From the podcast, wildest girl of the year. I mean, this person might get two of them, but just to, so that way we don't have overload of people that we talking about here. And I hate to use it from the same. You know what? A lot of people came out of that first podcast.
I think
podcast is like University of Miami where they put out all these professional players. That first live podcast, people came out and they showed their ass, and people came out and showed their greatness in that podcast. I would really want to say that because it's two women from that podcast that really showed out. But yeah, I mean, we don't know her name, but it was a young lady there. She was the reason we named it what we named it. She fucked under a semi truck. She was cool with fucking with girls. She was fucking guys, hamsters, just all types of wild shit. She showed up and she just barely missed it. Like barely missed Rap Talk. Rap Talk just took over, but she was right behind them. She was like right there in the MVP votes. So she's the wildest girl in my opinion. We don't have a name for it, but shout out to the light-skinned girl with the glasses on.
Light-skinned girl with the glasses.
She know who she is. Shout out for June.
Semi-truck.
Shout out to CDL. She was talking about fucking under a semi-truck. That's dangerous. But she talked that shit. So shout out to the queen one time. Wildest girl. Nationally, is it a wild girl? I guess Brittany Winter would get that because the fact that she went to Jackson State and said, hey, listen, hide your sons because I will fuck them and have a baby by them.
Yeah.
So shout out to Brittany Renner. That's not wild. I think that's just kind of clout chasing.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I was thinking.
I think that's a little clout chasing.
So we just gonna keep it local then. We gonna keep it on podcast.
We'll keep it on brand.
Okay, and keeping in that same vein of on brand, rookie of the year.
Rookie of the year is it's a landslide. It's no question. It's Ja Morant. She will be Lovie. She was literally on the last podcast. I met Lovie. Probably I didn't even realize I met her. She hit me up before I did the men cheating pod, men cheating too. Why do men cheat too? Panel. She was one of the panelists, and we talked and we kicked it. Then she came and did the poetry night, and she killed us with this poem. And then she came to the podcast and performed the poem better than she did the first time. And it was almost like when Erykah Badu did Tyrone live for the first time, it was like, oh, this the one we gonna do? Fuck what you recorded in the studio. This is the one. She came on here, peed in a nigga mouth. Or a nigga peed in her mouth. She put heels on him, fucked him, jacked him off upside down with his legs up. He came, it went down his ass. She ate the cum from between his ass cheeks. I don't know if we can talk like this, but it's the last podcast of the year. And then once we got off air, she gave us more gems that we can't even talk. I can talk about it, but I'm not. Like she said niggas' names, like the niggas she was talking about, niggas in politics, niggas that's in the media. He'll park. We gonna block that shit. Don't sue us, Channel 2. Put the camera back on me. Don't sue us, Channel 2. We just talking shit. It's the 363rd day of the year, my baby. We having a good time. That's the rookie of the year, the unanimous. Nobody else came on here like for their first time and showed up and performed like she did. Shout out to you, Lovie Dove. And I see you hitting the gym. I wish I could have brought you over to my dog, Jason Jameson, who was a comedian and a trainer. Had I known you was trying to get the body get right for the 2022, because we all going into 2022 celibate and discipline, I would have hooked you up with Jason Jameson. Mm-hmm. My main man, he got me tight right. I think he'd have got you tight right. We're going to take you from that nigga over there at Planet Fitness. He ain't going to do nothing but try to fuck you. I'm going to tell you that now. So you heard it here first. We're going to get you from there, and we're going to bring you over there to Dearborn Heights, and we're going to tighten you up and get you right.
All right. So first, the podcast that he's speaking of, if you follow us, now that's one that was actually in video too. So Why Is She Saying I Don't Need a Man? That's the Why Is She Saying I Don't Need a Man podcast. That was December 16th, 2021. It was definitely a classic episode. Funny as hell. So check that out. If you haven't checked that out, that story was wild. You know, everybody was floored and kind of to the point where it's like, okay, the poem, and it starts off early. So if you watch the podcast, like damn near 7 minutes in, she goes right into it. I was like, can you give her the poem? And then Josh was like, hey man, we ain't trying to put people on spot like that. And I was like, nah, they gotta hear this shit. And she was like, fuck it. And she went at it. And like he said, she delivered even more, like to the point where like you're listening and it's just the audio of it. You're thinking, what the fuck? And I'm glad we got video, because I'm sure that everybody listening is like, what does she look? I gotta see this shit. I gotta see the performance of this poetry.
Go watch this assistant principal looking young lady come out here and show y'all just how nasty women really are. And like, man, we nowhere near nasty as women can get. Nowhere near as nasty. And I want to say this, I know y'all think y'all slick, but I'm already ready for it. 2022, all you women who was fine and got your body didn't got fat asses, y'all about to buy tax services, and y'all gonna be out here getting niggas to come do taxes with y'all because y'all fine as hell and thick than a motherfucker, and all they using is TurboTax. Because I'm seeing a bunch of women pop up that I follow, and they attractive, and they got a lot of followers, and all of a sudden now they got tax companies. And I'm like, you ain't no certified public accountant. Like, what are you doing here? You just got a fat ass and some big titties. But now all of a sudden you're gonna be asking me for my social security number and my W-2. So I just want y'all to know that I see that what's coming on, and I'm predicting the future now. Okay. I see what y'all on, and I'm peeping it.
All right, so yeah.
But if you want to be sponsored by the podcast, I'm down for it. I'm not gonna knock your hustle if you want to give me a couple dollars to be promoted on here, and I will promote the fuck out of you. But leave that, cousin.
All right, so along those lines, the next category.
Happy birthday, Denzel Washington.
Yeah, for sure. Shout out.
I get off you
another Capricorn.
Rest in peace, John Man.
Drunk moment of the year.
Drunk moment of the year. I mean, it's been so many because we indulge on this podcast. But I guess it would have to be Ron Taylor, because Ron got so drunk that he called his mama while he was on the podcast and got mad because we was doing he brought the conversation up. We was arguing about R&B singers, and he was like, who make the best sex music? And he argued about how we was drafting and who we could draft. And then he stopped and called his mom on the phone. So that was my drunk. Ron Taylor gets the drunkest moment of the podcast. Cause I look like, nigga, you wouldn't do that on Joe Rogan shit. Nigga, don't get drunk on this bitch and get the trip. So that would be it. My baby Ron Taylor out in California. Yeah. All Def Digital alumni, Motown Lab King. The drunkest moment of the year. You know what I'm saying? My dog goes to my baby, Ronald.
Okay.
Taylor.
Okay. And then for the classic, and we started telling a lot of these stories. So simp story of the year.
We started the simp shit.
I mean, what's funny, we started it before as the tail end, but Dave Jizzle dropped some classic gems on simping.
But he didn't even know he was simping. That's the thing about it. It's even sadder. Like, when you don't know you simping, that you a simp, that's even sadder when you think you in control of what's going on. It's like, bro, you a whole simp out here. Like, when you take a girl out to a concert and buy her shoes and send her flowers, and she like, nigga, I don't want none of this from you. Like, and that's not how it happened, but, you know, that's how it happened. I mean, it's a lot of simp stories. Like,
And then I think, but the most painful one was the story that other Josh told. Was like, that shit was fucked up.
Oh, what did he do? Did he have like somebody call her? He paid like Fiverr. He went to what's that shit? Cameo?
Yeah.
And had somebody hit her
up.
Yeah,
like Omarion. Did he have Omarion call her for her birthday? And
damn, I forgot about that. Man, I was gonna get Josh.
That was a tough one. That was a tough one.
That might have been a simp story of the year. You know what I'm saying? That young brother didn't do nothing but want to love her. And then he was trying to put her together and build her up. And then she was hanging out with her ex. Mm-hmm. And I think her ex walked a dog or some weird shit was going on. Like he was watching the dog. I don't remember what podcast was that, so they can go back and listen to that one. That was a simp story of the year.
Let's see.
That was a simp story of the year. Josh came through and really showed out. He came on with his homeboys. And, you know, they was picking with him and fucking with him. But they don't get it. That's how the game go. You're going to get dunked on. Daytime is coming. Daytime probably already came. But niggas going to get on here and act like they ain't never been through shit. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Western Michigan Broncos. I did a show for them Friday, and they had a bowl game Monday and they beat the shit out of Nevada. So shout out to them, man. That was good fun. Shout out to Coach Lester and them for having us come down and kick it. I ain't even gonna lie, I was scared. End of the show, nigga. I shook every nigga hand in there. It's like 100 niggas on a football team. And you know, a lot of hand sanitizer. But them boys went out there and did their goddamn thing. Shout out to the Western Michigan Broncos. Shout out to my nigga Big E, a Western Michigan alumni. Copacetic right. Hour podcast. Yep.
All right, so Josh is taking a vow of celibacy is the episode, and that was August 23rd, 2021. Also, in keeping up with these different episodes, the story of Ron Taylor, that was July 19th, 2021, and it's the best sex music in Josh Comedy Weekend celebration. We were previewing that. The sex music conversation was also very incoherent than a motherfucker.
It was, because he was drunk. I mean, we was all drunk, but he was super fucked up. But it was a good talk, because it was like, all right, yeah, it was, we make the best sex music. And I think we was like, we was drafting people.
I mean, it's
this, I forgot what the argument was. It was like,
I don't know what it is about some of your other Motown Laugh Kings between Jeff and Ron, but they, and I'm not even an R. Kelly fan like you, but when they come to music, fucking music, if you were born, I assume like 1970 up, R. Kelly probably, well, 1970 to probably
after
95.
After Al Green, oh, not Al Green, after Marvin Gaye, it was like,
yeah, that's what I was gonna say. It was
R. Kelly.
It's R. Kelly. Like, it, and we came up with Janet Jackson after that, but it's like, not R. Kelly by a huge landslide.
Everybody was fruit off R. Kelly tree at that point. Like, it was like, it was like, Marvin laid the soil down and R. Kelly grew from it. Mm-hmm. And shit, everybody else from that point was like, yeah, they are fruit off his tree, a Trey songs. Whoever you hear talk about it, nigga, like, you know, 12 Plays was an album that was crazy, and the only album competed was Toni Braxton, and she needed Babyface.
Yeah.
It took two icons to fuck up one nigga. Not to say he didn't have writers on the album, but whatever, man. We get to talk about R. Kelly and him. We seem like we support his old pedophilia. We don't. He just made great music.
Yeah, yeah. We separate the
art. While he was doing that fuck shit.
Art from the man.
The nigga away.
Speaking of which, R&B album of the year. That moves us right into that topic.
And this is on me. Personally, this is my thing here. You know what I'm saying? These niggas won't even be able to jump into it because they don't even fuck around. You know what I'm saying? These niggas swimming in the kiddie pool. These young men are swimming in the kiddie pool. And this is just something that's near and dear to my goddamn heart. But it is Snow Allegra, Temporary Highs in the Violet Skies. In the Violet Skies. This young lady right here out of Poland. Album Scandalous. She going on tour right now. I don't know when her album came out. Not her. Her is in the artist, her. Mm-hmm. That was a close second, in my opinion. It came out this year, low key. But it's tough. It's tough.
Then you had me listen to that what you call it, the Jasmine Sullivan. Do you count that?
That Jasmine Sullivan album. All those albums are up for R&B album of the year. It's gonna be a tough one right there with that one, because those three are like my shit. The Jasmine Sullivan was cool. Hers is hard. I might even have to flip it to her. It depends on how I'm feeling on a given day. Her album is hard because that song Damage is like the best song of the year, in my opinion. Like Damage. That song itself is just a monster. But Snow Allegra, because I don't think a lot of people talk about it, a lot of people don't know about it, and it's very creative, and she got a lot of different sounds on there. So if I had to put it gun to my head, I would go with Snow Allegra, even though I feel like her gonna win it all when it comes to Grammys. But my personal pick, Snow Allegra, is the R&B album of the year. So I think y'all need to tap in with that, listen to that, get with you somebody at the top of the year. Don't, if you ain't got to go nowhere for New Year's, don't. Sit in the house, listen to some good music. Get some good accoutrements, whatever that's you into. You don't have to drink. You don't have to smoke. But if you do, make sure it's the good shit. And just sit at the crib, man. Create your own vibe and chill, man. Ain't no reason to go nowhere, man. Because it's looking like that. It's looking like that that COV on some bullshit. You know what I'm saying? And if it is, just stay out the way.
Yeah, yeah. It's definitely ticking up. But, okay, let's talk a little bit about your R&B vibes. They come through. And what you suggest. Maybe not yours, but what do you suggest for the dude that's setting up in today's play? What's the R&B vibe for, let's say, a guy that's like 26, 27, you know, the kickback beyond just, you know, the classic Netflix and chill? Like, how do you set the mood for the conversation and the R&B in the background?
Well, bro, you always go and ask her what she into, but you can't never lose with just, bro. I mean, right now, Summer Walker is a vibration all her own. Her, you know what I'm saying? And if you and I do the YouTube, you know what I'm saying? I don't do the Spotify. I don't hook up my phone because you never know who might be trying to call and throw the whole vibe on. Might be a girl. But my thing is this.
Hilarious.
Sometimes my dog, you can't lose. Her, Snow Allegra, all those women trigger something. SZA, they trigger, and then they get to pulling up all that good music that these women like. And a lot of times they ain't even heard it. You know, some stuff they ain't heard. I put a young lady up on Snow Allegra, and you know, women love you for life when you put them on some new music, and then you always own that era. So whatever song that they come out, they always think of you. Like, I remember I told this girl this, listen, I want you to put a playlist together of all your favorite songs, and I want to fuck you to it. So that way, every time you hear them songs, you think of me. My nigga, that was some of the coldest shit God ever put in my mind to say to this bitch. Ever. Fucked her up. You can use that too. Just be like, listen, man, send me a list of all your favorite songs because I want to fuck you to all that music. All right. So that way, when every time you hear them songs, you think of the boy.
Now, I do got this question too. Because you definitely got me back in this whole kick of listening to R&B more modern, right?
Welcome back, my nigga.
So I got a couple different playlists, and some of this modern R&B go real explicit real fast. So like a Janae Aiko song, yes, could take it left real fast, real hard. And if you just kind of on the kickback, hey, what you been doing today? And then you hear, you know what I'm saying?
Pussy Fairy.
Yeah, so like how do you work the playlist where it ain't so... Damn, you know what I'm saying? Like, how do you set that up? I mean, because some of the music today jumps right out at
these
you.
Women are very sexually outward, like they cool with it, and I don't think any woman would be turned off by that. Like, if it's on, it come on, Pussy Fairy come on, she only gonna vibe to it. The music don't mean shit, it's how you play it. You can play the sexiest shit in the world and not try nothing. You know what I'm saying? Just because you play some sex shit don't mean I gotta fuck you. So just let it play. Like, I don't think you can really lose if you put on the right music. Like, if you put that music on and it's in the background and just let it do what it do, you straight. I don't think she gonna be like, if you just got a straight freaky ass, you know, playlist, nigga, you tripping. You know what I'm saying? Like, you and that motherfucker just going crazy, like, you know, Kanye, my neck, my back type shit. You doing too much. Good little vibe. Turn on some her. It's gonna lead you the rest of the way. The algorithm is gonna set up everything you need to do. It's gonna open up every door that you want to. And at that point, she gonna be like, oh, well, can you play this? And then once she hit her bag, it's gonna go where it have to go. So I'm just telling you, you can never go wrong right now with Jasmine Sullivan, Snow Allegra, her, and SZA. Because honestly, you play one of them, they all gonna lead to the same shit. They all gonna lead to them vibes, to all them vibrations. And let them women soothe that in there. Let that feminine energy come in, because then, you know, then Ari Lennox gonna come on and sit on it. And you know what I'm saying? Spit on it. I wanna sit on that motherfucker. And that shit gonna happen. It's gonna happen. You let Janae Aiko and Mila J talk her into coming up off that pussy. You ain't got to do nothing but sit back and be cool. And you know that she getting closer. And then you go to the bathroom and you be like, damn, it's getting hot in here. Turn the thermostat up. And you be like, I'm just getting out of my little hoop shorts. And make sure you cock your dick somewhere where she can see it. And you don't gesture to her. You just put it up there so that motherfucker is forthright. And then when she see it, y'all sitting there, y'all chilling and whatever. And then eventually hoop shorts is always, that's lingerie for men. I don't know what white guys be wearing. Put on some cargo pants, whatever you niggas be wearing, cargo shorts pants. Or whitey tighties. But come through hoop short. If you come hoop short, you put on the hoop short, she know what it is. Hoop shorts, nice fitted tee that look good on you. Look, you know what I'm saying? No. Your shape might be fucked up.
See, this that shit. You living across the street from your girl, and then you see some dude walk up in some hoop shorts with a charger around his neck and a beater on, and you like, what the fuck?
Well, that's why you supposed to be sitting across the street at your own house with some hoop shorts on and a beater on with a bitch coming over to come see you. With Donda banging out the motherfucking speakers you got in your backyard. But when she come over there, the vibe is set. So she know what it is. And then she see you get comfortable, she gonna get comfortable. Take her shoes off, kick her feet up on you. You know what I'm saying? And do what she love to do. Ryan hating on all your white musicians. He probably did. He don't think Justin Timberlake know how to get no pussy. But that's how you set the vibe, fellas. Hoop shorts, t-shirt, good drink. You know what I'm saying? Hoop shorts, t-shirt, good drink. Whatever you got over there, and then you let Janae Aiko and Jasmine Sullivan whisper in her ear, like, get that nigga some pussy. Because that's all that music is about. Give him some pussy, a good nigga. And then you go with that vibe, and it's going to take you where you go. I use YouTube, so sometimes I got commercials in mind, and that's okay.
I got commercials, so you...
It don't throw shit off. I let the commercial do what it do. You know what I'm saying? We let it play. They got to get their money, because I'm not going to pay for this shit. I'm gonna pay for it.
All right, what about the okay, so let's see. I go old school sometimes. I got candles and incense and shit. That's real
that's
old school.
That's a good vibe.
What about the other accoutrements? Because, you know, depending upon the age, the
candles
we talking
is
about 20, we talking, like I say, the 26, 27 year old dude, like, is he, you know, depending on her, she may want some, they all love it.
Nigga, I'm the king of, like, I'm the king of quarters, nigga. I'm the king of 25s, man. They all love it. I'm telling you what they own. You light a candle, you sit back, bro. I'm a minimalist. Less is more. They like the vibe. They sitting around, nothing going on, good food. You got snacks in there, whatever they like to eat. Drink is good, and the drink is unlimited. It ain't got to be unlimited. First of all, if she outweigh you, you shouldn't be buying no liquor no way, because you know what I'm saying? You ain't going to be able to hang with her. But a lot of times, you outweigh her. So if y'all sitting over there drinking, she can't handle all of the liquor y'all got over there. So you got the drink, and it's coming through. Got the chase. It's good. The liquor is going. The candles is lit. You chilling. So you can, at that point, all that good music gonna do what it's supposed to do, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Betty Wright gonna sing some of this. Betty Wright gonna talk into that pussy. And then you let Kells come through when he come through. When it happened, it happened.
All right, now let's work that vibe from the other angle.
Okay.
The movie versus the music play. What's the difference between them vibes?
It's a difference because if it's a movie, you really gotta pay attention to the movie. So if you watching a really good movie, like some shit that people get into, like, damn, y'all watching Squid Games, you really want to know what's going on in the story to know why, like, why 161 acting like a whole ass nigga. So you must not, unless you're just really trying to kick it. But if you're trying to really get somewhere with this girl, you got to play something like music is a good undertone. So you can jump in and out of music. A movie, you can't. So if you watching a movie, I mean, if you're going to watch a movie, fuck it. Just make sure some shit that, nigga, you can't never go wrong with Soul Plane, man. It's enough celebrities in Soul Plane to be like, oh, okay. And then it's not good enough. And it's terrible enough for y'all to just be able to start fucking when you can play a role where you like, damn, Kevin Hart. You like, wait a minute, Snoop Dogg, a pilot. Like, and you just get thrown off and you don't miss shit. You like, what the hell Hughley doing in the bathroom? And but you can just still get off like that. So if you're trying to fuck, Soul Plane always a good movie to put on and fuck to in the background. But don't watch, like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
don't watch like a
Godfather
Denzel Washington,
Harlem and shit like
don't
that.
Watch like a Denzel Washington movie.
Yeah, nigga, don't watch that. Nigga, don't watch great Great Debaters.
Yeah, Great Debaters.
Cause she gonna be like really paying attention to that shit. You can't watch nothing like that. Nigga, I'm telling you, nigga, Soul Plane is the movie to fuck to.
So it's like, that's what's so weird. It's like, so for if you watching something, it needs to be more surface and things you can't pay attention to. But that's if the music, you got to set the atmosphere a whole lot more with the music.
The music subconsciously sets in and does what it's supposed to do. A movie distracts you from what you're doing because you might be trying to grab a titty and she's like, move. Because that sensation of playing with her titty is fucking her up. Like, why won't they just put John Q's son on the list? Like, she really want to know. Like, she don't want to be stimulated like that. She want to understand, like, why won't they put this boy on the list? Now, you watching, you know, music is just in the background. It's just, it's creating a loop and a vibe and putting her where she need to be. So it's like music, you can't go wrong because music live in your subconscious. A movie, you got to be right there for, you know, say up front with that shit. So don't watch no movies if you can. But like I said, if you do watch a movie, nigga, like I said, you cannot go wrong. You cannot go wrong with Soul Plane. Mm-hmm. And you cannot go wrong with the Jackson movie. You know what I'm saying? American Dream. Because that movie the movie long and everybody done seen it 100 times. It's a good movie to fuck to. You know what I'm saying? It's a good movie to fuck to. The Jackson 5, American Dream. You can't go wrong
what about,
with that.
What about the new hood movies? Can you throw on some Tubi shit?
I wouldn't do that because the movie's so bad, they good. You know what I'm saying? But you can always, Tubi is full of movies you can fuck to all through that. You can turn them on and just fuck because it's all like, it's niggas in Jacksonville selling dope, getting robbed, killing somebody. It's niggas in Dallas selling dope, robbing, killing somebody. It's niggas in Toledo, they having a threesome, the lady crazy, she killed the other lady, and now the husband done got her pregnant because she done got him drunk. And it's the same thing about this movie in Delaware. All the same, Tubi is full of hood movies that you can fuck to. So if you want to go that route, you can. But them movies be so bad that it might turn her off like, this dumb. It got to be good enough for her to be like, Soul Plane work because it's like, look at these celebrities. Ooh, there go Monique. There go Lonnie Love. You know what I'm saying? To where you gonna watch it. Because you like, this supposed to be good, but then it end up not being. Like, watch some more in the bathroom with Ryan Hooks. Mm-hmm. You watch that. It got to be, good enough to keep her, but then it's just stupid and fade back to the background. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I never go movie. I go because I want to talk. And movies you can't talk to.
Yeah.
Music, you can talk over music and this, that, and the third, and then you're talking about takes. Music, you cannot go wrong. Music turns your situation into the movie. Mm. Turn your shit to the movie.
I like it. All right. All right. So along that play, all right, as the music is playing, what about food? Let's set the whole setting for the little homie because, you know, I think different food bring different type of energy too. What you going for?
Oh man, nigga, I hate saying what I do because I'm a different type of nigga. What work for me. I don't know why. God bless me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, I always go for whatever they want, what they like, but it's like, you know, 9 times out of 10, nigga, I got a Manhattan chicken from up the street from me, nigga. So it's like, what you want? You want some fries? You want some wings? You want some shrimp? Whatever she want, you get her. You make it comfortable enough for her to eat and pig out in front of you, and you don't give a fuck about crumbs on her shirt and all that. So me, I go chicken wings, whatever, you know what I'm saying? We go grab whatever she likes. So I don't know what to tell you, but if you set the vibes the way I'm telling you to set them bitches, she gonna, all that superficial shit gonna fall out the window. You know what I'm saying? Crab legs and let's go get all that. That's for something else. We at the crib kicking it. This is some old natural, we chilling type shit. The vibes is what it is. We're here kicking and having a good time. I'm learning you learning me. This is how you build. This is how you end up fucking in missionary position for like 25 minutes, my nigga. 25 minutes of missionary sex. Loving it. Legs wrapped around. You in her ear. Put a hickey on her motherfucking neck, nigga. We turning up.
Hilarious.
I'm sucking on your neck.
Hilarious.
Come on this dick. And can still hear Kevin Hart and Method Man in the background in the other room talking.
It's on the scene with
hey man, the pilot fell out.
Godfrey and the
shout out to the big homie Godfrey. And Godfrey, we trust, man. Go holler at his podcast.
Godfrey fall out of the hot tub.
Quit playing with me, man.
All right. So here go. We going back to the awards that we giving out for the Josh Adams Josh Adams show. So now that leads us to, and we had a lot of wild ones for this one. Story of the year on the podcast. It was a lot of crazy stories this year.
But it can only be one though.
It can only be one on some what was that?
The Highlander.
Highlander shit. It so I can pitch out a couple. So
yeah, I mean you
so
can pitch out one.
Pitch
I don't
out
need
a couple for I the for the category. So you got JD talking about the lifestyle, and it was like kind of that was a collection of stories, but I kept pushing him to the point where he was like, shut up, Khary. but I was yeah, I had true. To push JD. Because I had to find out, like, okay, how did you keep staying in this world of the lifestyle? So for people that don't know the lifestyle is basically people that's in the swinging. And let's see, what episode was that? That was episode... That was JD and the lifestyle. That was November 10th, 2021. JD and the lifestyle, swingers. And he actually brought two young ladies that... That swung with him on the show as well. It was very revealing. So that was a story, him getting into swinging. You also had other stories that were classic, I think. Let's see. You had the classic story of... Man, the Joshua story, the super simp story. That was
simp of the year. So you
that probably, was simp of the year. So we gonna that's yeah. already won an award.
Yeah, he already got one.
Let's solidify. Let's see.
I already know who I'm gonna go with. I don't even know why you even
foolish. I already think I know who you're gonna go with. Foolish told the story of the SWAT team coming up to WJLB.
That's legendary.
And trying to find him. Like, and it was the producer at the show. That helped him get out of that goddamn situation. That was April 3rd, 2021. That was a classic episode.
100.
Because he broke down the whole story. And then it's also rare foolish because foolish be joking and shit and most times. But I think he was real serious that episode. Like he kind of just kicked game that episode with us. You know what I'm saying? So it's rare to catch foolish in that presence of mind.
You get vulnerable like that for sure.
Yeah. Let's see. Okay, no, that's definitely not necessarily a story. Desada Baby smashing whinings. That was a funny Was that this year? Funny episode.
Hey, shout out to my dog Nicholas Divine, man. He done sent through $25, man. Appreciate that for the year, man.
For sure, for sure. Let's see. Are you buying hair care products at Home Depot?
Oh, shout out to my guy. That was my guy, Nate. Nate told a story about getting left by his girl on COVID. That was
that was that year. Yeah, that was definitely one of those stories.
That was one of those, but that wasn't the one.
Nah, but that was a heavy story because
Christina, I gotta get you on the podcast, man. Christina, man, if this is what I think it is,
that was a wild story that Nate told.
I don't think that's her.
When Nate told the story, I was thinking he was talking about somebody else, but he was like, "No, that shit happened to me." And he healed her through COVID, and she was dealing with she had long-term effect COVID. Like she hit it like really.
She got hit with the OG COVID that was fucking people heads up, like shit that was taking you out the game. And he was in there like not knowing what was going on and healed her back to health and everything. And she left him as soon as she got back, nigga. As soon as she was able to taste and smell, nigga, she got out and in the wind on my nigga. But that ain't it. That's one though.
Yeah. So
that ain't it though.
So that definitely, I think, one of the funniest stories to me, but it really wasn't the story. It was more so the song at the end when we did a rendition of Be Careful from R. Kelly and Sparkle.
Well, that was about the one.
Male Friends.
Oh, yeah. That was a story about when a young lady that I was that I've been dealing with for a minute. I found out that I'm thinking we getting back together, just the long or the short. I'm thinking we getting back together, everything is what it was, you know, traveling nurse. And she come home, I get her nails did, and then come to find out, like, you know, a week, maybe two later, I find not even a week, nigga. I think nigga, she still smell like the salon. And I hit her, she like, oh, I'm out with a friend. And I'm like, a friend? Because, you know, when girls don't say the name, because she always like, girl, I'm out with Bridget. If they don't do that, they out with a nigga. And I'm like, oh. And then she broke it down like, well, I mean, we not together. I was like, well, I didn't know that because I would have been dropping dick over in bitches had I known that we was living like that. And I wouldn't have got your motherfucking nails did for you to be out here wrapping it around shot glasses with a nigga, some nigga from the NFL. Like, you know what I'm saying? I would have never motherfucking did that. But that ain't it either. But that motherfucker right there, that's a simp story. I should have never did that.
Okay. And it was classic because that also is where we talk about Lori Harvey, Mr. White Folks, and Head was on that episode. Shout out to Head.
Yeah. And shout out to Mr. White Folks and Reckless Eyeballing.
Mr. White Folks, but definitely the story of the year, I think. Most people know this was from House Party 2. And House Party 2, episode, let's see, it was dropped December 1st, the Black Friday edition. It was from Dukez. Break it down.
Basically, the story of the year came from a label mate, from my sister podcast.
Figuring out with Dukez.
Figuring it out with Dukez. She's an amazing storyteller by mistake. She don't really like, you know, some people just good storytellers. She good at it and she don't even know she good at it. Like she just be talking and giving it how, you know, she be giving it how it's supposed to be gave, just to steal a little lingo from the women. And she broke a story down about how she met a guy or knew a guy from her past. He was in the army and then they, you know, the long distance thing and they kicked it. And he convinced her to move all the way from Arizona out to Chirac, out to where it go down at, you know what I'm saying? O-Block. And had her move all the way there, not only to live with him, but she wasn't going to live with him because he was living with somebody else. And it wasn't like he was living with a sister or a cousin. He was living with a friend's girl. And she sent all her stuff out there, and dog just went missing on her. And she was homeless in Chicago.
Because the friend, wait. Okay, so she was moving in with a man. And that man was living with his homeboy. His homeboy was living with his girlfriend. The homeboy and the girlfriend break up. And now the man she was going to, I guess, move in with, his homeboy's ex-girlfriend now got all of her belongings. Continue.
I mean, these are kids, too. These ain't grown people. These are like 21, 19, 18, whatever. So relationships come and go and fade. And dog basically disappeared on her for like 3 months. She ended up having to live with somebody, grandma. And then the nigga popped up and came back, and then she gave the nigga some pussy immediately. And then the person that she was staying with was like, "You're homeless, and then you gonna fuck a nigga in the house, and you've been living here, and you don't have no job, and you out here on some old intern type shit," and they kicked her out.
All right, so and then even more of this. So basically, she was coming from Arizona to Chicago, and upon going to Chicago, the reason that she was excited about going to Chicago because she had won the opportunity to serve in a fancy restaurant in the Chicago area. And she also was excited about seeing the man that she was dating at the time.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm assuming this is like an online connection that she made or whatever. Shout out Black Planet or something, because it's back in the day. And when she arrived in Chicago, the man was nowhere to be found. She had to track down her belongings, and she knocks on the door, sees another woman at the door, and she says, "Hey, is man X here?" And she's like, "Man X is gone because he got his ass out when I kicked my man out." And that's who had everything going on. So at that point in time, it changes the dynamics of everything. And as the dynamics change of everything, she was distraught. And one of her friends from college at the time in Arizona said, "Hey, I'm from Chicago. My family is willing to let you stay with them." Mm-hmm. And they stayed in a high-end neighborhood. For people that know Chicago, like the high-end neighborhood.
We doing this story, no justice. You got to listen to her tell that bitch.
Exactly.
Because you got to hear, because she still love that nigga. Mm-hmm. A little bit, like that's still in her, and you can hear her tell a story like, "Well, you know," and bitch, oh my God. So you got to listen to the second podcast that we did live, the second house pod we did, bro. Listen to that, and that's just straight. Listen to that second podcast, that house pod we did, bro. When I tell you, it is some of the best. It's the greatest 15 minutes in podcast history. You never gonna hear nothing better than that, dog. We need to make that an NFT. I don't even know how to do that shit, a non-fungible token shit, but that was the, like, I love the fact that this podcast has not been heard by a lot of people yet, and it's kind of like having private conversations with people that we fuck with. And when people go back and dissect the shit that we've talked about on here, they gonna try to cancel niggas, but they gonna really put us on a level that we should be at, like Mark Twain-esque type shit come off this podcast from some of the most regular people you would ever meet. Like, this is the greatest podcast on, this is one of the greatest forms of entertainment out here. Like, and then it ain't got shit to do with me. It's the people we've had on here. And, yeah. And they don't even know.
No.
They don't even know yet, bro. I feel like
no.
We like this corned beef sandwich that niggas don't even know about till they go on dives and done, whatever that show called that whatever they do. Dive in,
diners, and drive, diners, whatever, dives and drives or something,
whatever, with them white niggas. It's so many jewels, and we just be fucking around up here, and it don't, and I think, I hope it's gonna continue, but I think it's because we know ain't nobody watching or listening that we had these great ass conversations with people, and when people really dig into this shit, it is gonna be sick, the shit people gonna hear on here and be like, "What the fuck is going on?" It's just, it's other words. So Quiava, you get it. Like, literally, she probably did it 2 times. If we'd have did the awards the time she did it before.
That was a wild story, too. Almost got pimped.
She turned into a prostitute.
And Nick is saying the gender reveal, that was last year.
Oh, Nick, that was scandalous. Yeah, that was
hard. That was a classic one, too. That was a classic one, along with the Almost Got Pimped. And I believe the episode is called Almost Got Pimped.
Go back to that one, man. It's like season one. I don't know what season we had.
Yeah, it was like she was a prostitute intern. She was every time
some got something to do with secondary education, she do some dumb shit. She went to Arizona and came from there and went there. She almost became a prostitute, and the nigga didn't buy her no Wendy's, and that's the reason that it didn't happen. Quiaba's an amazing storyteller, bro. And I mean, she don't know it on, and like, I'm not gonna say we bring the best out of her. She just tell a hell of a story, man.
I still think Seven Baby Mamas from JD is the best story ever told on here, which is
that's hard, but it's like he is in denial. That's why that one don't go crazy, because it's like you listening to a person not take accountability for coming in seven, you know, however many people you get to make seven babies. Quiava was she was just in there. She didn't know what was going on. She was didn't understand that this nigga was gonna be like, "I need you to suck that dick for $25. She didn't know. Quiava just different, man. She just on another level, man.
That, and then also it this it, the weird story, June telling the story of moving in with his girl next to Infinity was very classic too, because Infinity talking about all the wild shit Infinity talking about,
that's unfair,
next
because
to June,
yeah,
was,
that's, you gotta tell, like, none of this stuff is up because on this season, because this old, yeah, we can't, yeah, even put this here, yeah, but we just letting y'all know it's so many gems in the archives that somebody gonna have to give us damn near 8 figures to get the catalog. Because now that I'm sitting back thinking about this shit, when we just was on here talking and nobody was really listening and we couldn't go live and we just in here, like, I don't go get famous people. Like, I know niggas. I know some people that y'all might be interested. Like, Ryan Davis came through on some weirdo shit because Ryan brought him through. But it's, mm-hmm, like, I mean, I'm sure I can go get the hottest niggas and be like, hey, can you go to my podcast? We just had good conversations on here with people we just know. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times, you know, I ain't my favorite people. I don't like these motherfuckers sometimes, but they come on here and they get a platform and we talk and we have real conversation. And we come on this platform and we allow people, we give people the room or the leverage to be wrong. We let Dave come on here and be wrong. Cardi's been wrong on here a lot. I've been wrong, yes, on here. I've been wrong on here more than I've been right.
I got my ass kicked by Heather and them.
Yeah, I've been wrong more than I've been right on here. I come on here and tell y'all, bear my soul on here. I want y'all to see me say, I'm single. I got a girl. I'm single. I got a girl. Man, I'm about to focus on me. No, man, I got my girl now. I'm in the streets. Man, I'm back in the house. I want to come home. Looking in the camera, say, I want to come home. This podcast is special, man. And it's the first time I ever said that. And I don't know if it's because I'm off this Casamigos that's been here since the second house party. I don't know if this shit go. I don't know if this shit spoil or not. But I'm going to finish it off for the year over with, because I don't want to bring no old tequila into 22. Because we celibate and we discipline all 22. I'm keeping my dick to myself. You can't suck this or ride this motherfucker.
Okay. So that brings us to almost canceled moment of 2021.
All right. The almost canceled moment goes to the nigga working the boards right now, dog. In my opinion. We had a podcast on here where we had a label mate that was on here from his problem, her words. How's that going?
His fault, her problem.
His fault, her problems. And we had my baby girl on here. Her name is
Shari from His Fault, Her Problem was here.
It was here. And we was talking about just, you know, when you in a relationship, are you kicking? And, you know, if a girl come over your crib, like how I just set the vibe up, right? Girl come over, music playing, we drinking. And me and this girl has had sexual, we done fucked around before. She fall asleep naked, but I just didn't fuck because we was asleep. So I start fucking her while she not awake. And she looked like, what? And then Khary was like, Shark, you telling me you ain't never woke up and a nigga was fucking you?
I'm gonna make you say some wild shit from time to time.
Man, that nigga was not even drinking that day. Khary was on water. And he just spoke his truth. He spoke his truth. He was just like, because, and then she made us all feel weird, which honestly, that shouldn't even be the moment. Nope, that ain't even the moment that get us canceled. Nope, I'm not gonna give you that award. But you was wild because you said it with so much confidence. And she was like, what? Khary was like, you ain't never woke up and a nigga was fucking you.
Okay, the thing is, the thing that make it almost canceled, because the way her response was like, I was talking completely creep, and she ain't know none of this shit. Like, she was like, what are you talking about, Khary?
Bullshit.
And I'm like, you done got a dude, you done asked
woke you up to some dick.
And was like, I'm pleading the same case with the same energy. Like, you've acted sleep, but you knew you was up, and the dude was like, all right, let's see what's going on. Let's
I
work
fell
these
asleep
angles.
Before you did, and let me, you sleep to the side. I'm gonna pick this ass cheek up, and I'm gonna put my dick right there. I'm gonna put a little bit on the head. Hey, before I go any further, most valuable commenter and most loyal listener goes to Riri off top.
Oh, definitely.
Off goddamn top. Hey, Riri, I don't know if you got no liquor on you right now. We doing an award show, but you listen to this podcast consistently. You be in here commenting, talking your shit. A lot of times when ain't nobody in there, you the only one in there, and you be giving real talk. And this is a little more than I need to be having, but because this is for you, loyal listener and consistent.
And bow-legged cousin, as we found out as well.
No, that's not her. You got her fucked
that
up.
That wasn't her.
That wasn't Riri. Okay. That was Gemini 9. We never heard from again. Riri came out to the recording of the special, which is dropping next year. Mm-hmm. And she is constantly on here doing her thing, paying attention and watching and just fucking with us. And we love you to death. And I'm going to take this shot for you. I ain't planning on doing this whole shot. I'm going to be done after this shit.
All right.
But we're going to do the cancel in a moment. But and Khary said that, and it didn't make it no better because my dog was on here home. Also, business owner, good friend of mine.
That was an unreleased episode. Unreleased.
Oh, that bitch never dropped, episode. Did it?
Yeah.
So. And he came so strong, he was like, man, I don't give a fuck. I'm fucking hoes when they sleep.
Wait, Tom.
I might be making more.
We ain't say who. So
no, we
did.
Yeah. He was just like, man, I don't give a fuck. I mean, I love fucking sleepy bitches. I was like,
he definitely came through with he had the Cosby vibes. He took where I was coming from times a thousand.
Yeah, he made Khary sound just like he was all Khary. Like, I ain't say all that now. But if I had to say moment that might have got somebody canceled or was talking crazy, I mean, just in recent memory, would be put it like this. And before I say this one, because it's the most recent, I'm gonna say this. JD had the most canceled moment that we could have ever had, and we made sure we didn't hear it. Because when we was doing that podcast about lifestyle, he made that white girl pull her titties out on some Black Snake Moan type shit. This the stuff y'all don't see. Like JD set it up where she was downstairs, and like we talking to him, and you can't see the setup, but we talking to him like, you know, he be in the, like on here it's like a backstage, but we can still see him. And we talking like, all right, JD, we gonna talk about Wooty Woo. He like, yeah. And then like a white girl comes out the background with a robe on. And I'm like, who is this? And he set this shit up. And he was like, come here, sit down. And she come walk over and sit down. He like, yeah, this such and such. You want to do the podcast? She like, yeah, woo, 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 woo. So she sit down and he like, yeah, pull your titties out. And she pull these little, you know, not anyway, she pulled her titties out. They were some titties. You know, they wasn't my speed. I would, hey, somebody sucking on them and they would like to suck on them. But that was the moment that could have got us canceled, but it never happened. That was the greatest one. Khary's was wild because that nigga should conduct himself better than that. He's a man of the community. JD is a 50-year-old fucking grandfather having bitches pull their titties out on motherfucking live stream. What is this shit called?
Stream Yard.
But the moment that could have possibly got a canceled that got aired is when Marie started talking about that shit, that stuff that happened at Oxford. And her views on it was very, like, not thought out. I know she had good intentions with what she was saying, but they just wasn't hitting. And in this world we live in, they would have got her all the way the fuck out of here. What is Marie Ree saying?
Okay, she said, love you. Okay, she said, love y'all. Everything y'all doing is dope. Keep it up. She appreciated the thanks or the shout out, and she also appreciated let's see. She just laughing at as crazy as this shit is. Riri, you definitely got mad love for you for tuning in and keeping this shit going. You know, like, subscribe, share, all the good shit. And you definitely one of the soldiers in the mix as we keep growing of everything we doing. And actually, I know you said we about to rap. We got categories we got? One, two. We got one, two.
We had 122. Let's get these.
We got two more categories, and then I got the song. I think the song of the day, we're going to have a great lyrical breakdown.
We're going to finish strong. So, like I said, I was finished with the drink. I took a shot, but I didn't. I'm going to finish this, Neho, because fuck it. You know, all I got to do is go to work tomorrow. You always got to do something tomorrow. Somebody give a fuck about that. Again, shout out to EJ. We love you, my boy. Shout out to Joe. Who makes this thing go down, man? Shout out to everybody, man. Shout out to everybody. Shout out to Sunny. We doing good work. We building on some other shit, man. Shout out to everybody, man. We keeping it moving. So I don't know what Khary doing. He pulling up another tab right now. Mm-hmm. But yes, I was wondering if you were going to bring her up. She had a couple of comments that would have been cancellation time. Most definitely. She was talking crazy, but you know, sometimes people get on the microphone and they Marie. Talk crazy. Shout I mean, she came up here with a McFish, and I mean, a lot of times, man.
McDonald's.
That take niggas. That McFish had you say some wild shit. Dave Johnson, what's up, my baby boy? I don't know who that is, but what's up? I think that's my cousin. Go to that.
Okay, yeah.
I think that might be my cousin, Dave Johnson. Let's see. I can't really see his shit.
Let's see. You see? Is that your cousin?
Johnson? Is that Dave Jizzle?
Is that Dave Jizzle?
Man, that looks like a Dave Jizzle ass picture.
Dave Jizzle got the he tried to throw on like the
man, that's a picture he put up on
the black frames.
That's some shit he put up on Crush Spot. Dave Jizzle, you got on black
Crush Spot.
Shout out to my nigga Dave Jizzle. He would have came on, but he couldn't come today.
A classic guest.
Oh, classic guest. Classic
we got guest of the year coming up too.
Do we guest of the year?
Yeah. We got guest of the year.
This nigga making up shit. Did we cover everything? I talked about Western Michigan. Shout out to J Bill, man. They about to move out to Atlanta. I love you, boy. Good luck out there, man. Anything you need, hit me up. Yep, that's Dave Jizzle for sure. That nigga last name Johnson. Something ain't right about the Johnsons.
You won Simp Story of the Year, sir. As crazy as it is.
Did he win? No, Joe. Josh won that.
Oh yeah, Josh
won that. You was in the running.
Wait. Yeah, he was in the
running. Josh won that because he got did bogus.
Yeah.
I don't know what we finna do down here, but I want to just tell this story, man. I want to get this off my chest. This something from the vault. We got a lot of shit in the vault that this ain't never been in the vault, but we probably gonna release a lot of shit from the vault now because I think statutes of limitations up on a lot of shit out here. I remember one time I hosted this erotic poetry show, and at the time I might have just said too much. But anyway, I did a thing. I did a erotic poetry show, and somebody that I was with at the time, me and her, we went and hung out for my big cousin's birthday. And we went to the spot and we kicked it. And at the time I was kicking it. And when I say big cousin, it really wasn't like somebody I'm really related to, but they so close that they're a cousin. So not a play cousin, but like she was close enough to be a cousin. Like my big cousin was really super tight with some chicks that's like her sisters. They best friends, but they sisters, so she's like my big cousin. So we went, kicked it. My cousin had everybody out kicking it. Everybody drinking. They see my girl. They like, all right, this your girl. They getting her drunk. They didn't know that at the time I was fucking one of the daughters of my cousin's friend. Nobody knew that but me and her. So they getting my girl drunk. She fucked up. So the whole time I'm sitting there, when my girl would go off, I'm all on, oh, girl, grabbing her titties and feeling on her. And niggas looking, and I'm drunk as fuck. So this might be a drunk moment of the year.
The off-camera, the off-episode drunk moment of the year.
So they looking at me like, they didn't even know we knew each other like that. So imagine you see two people that you don't even think know each other like that till you look over at me, and I got a handful of titty in a club. And I got titty. And then my cousin was like holding me up like, nigga, your girl coming. So I got right. So they got my girl so fucked up that we get to the house. We get back to the room. She's so fucked up. She drunk. She go to sleep. Now, if that was Khary, oh boy, they would have tried to fuck her.
You see how he do. You can't give Josh an inch.
If that was Khary or my man, they would have tried to fuck her like she'd woke up with dick in her. But I had too much respect for my girl.
He tried to make me Mr. Huxtable out this motherfucker.
So my nigga Heathcliff would have fucked. So I chilled. Old girl pull up to my house, my apartment. I put on some hoop shorts. Remember what I said? Hoop shorts. It's like lingerie for a nigga. And I go outside and we start fucking in the car. My girl in the apartment sleep. I'm a taller nigga, so I can't really fuck in cars like that, especially little ass compact cars. I'm like, and I try to use a condom. I didn't want to use one, but I'm like, this shit ain't working. This car is weird. So we go down.
Ridiculous.
Yeah. So we go down to the laundry room in my apartment and we fuck downstairs. And I went back upstairs and I was looking around. You know, you thinking your girl, she was knocked out.
This is wildest boy of the year as well as drunkest moment of the year combined. This is like winning multiple categories. Like if this is the college football award, yeah. You come home with like all that shit.
Nigga, I'm Lauren Hill, nigga, at the Grammys. Cause I was ain't shit, nigga, and anything. I went to the bathroom, washed my dick off, and went and laid back in the bed with my girl, like. Scared, but she was so fucked up because they had her mixing and drinking. They didn't know they was just getting her drunk because it's my girl. They was showing her love, and I just fucked the whole bitch outside and downstairs in the laundry room. So I just want to tell that story, man, because I need confirmation for all the karma that I'm getting back in my life. Because I like to be like, why is all this happening to me? And then I have to remind myself, like, nigga, you fucked a bitch in the laundry room while the girl that loved you was in the bed asleep. Like, if she woke up, what was you going to say? Why you smell like pussy? I went over here to the little Bosco's and fish. You buy, we fry. Reread. Josh, you got a triple double. Yeah, I did. And trichomonas. No, I didn't get none. Which is funny. I didn't get nothing from the girl in the laundry room.
Here we go.
We ain't going to do that.
Here we go.
But that's the story I wanted to tell and get it off my chest. That's just stories from the vault right there, man.
Okay.
That's what that's the new segment, right? That's the part of the new segment where the hoes at. I was a hoe that day.
Hilarious.
The hoes was in the laundry room, and I ain't had no business doing that. I should have just took my girl home and made love to her as opposed to fucking this other girl in the laundry room. But that's the greed that come with a man. And I got to stop telling women my past because they judge you with about your past. Like, they be like, tell me about you. And then when you tell them these things, they use it against you to be like, well, what kind of nigga is you? I'm not telling nobody else shit about me. All right, Khary, let's continue on because we had an hour 30.
All right, so here we go. You gonna like this category.
I'm mad, I'm sick, I gotta come again. Yeah, Dave, you gotta come, my baby. We're gonna get you on, my nigga.
We,
get right.
we got this one. So, best lesson of the year. What did you learn most from this podcast this year?
That don't lie. Stop lying. Stop lying. And you ain't gotta fuck everybody. That's what I learned this year. And I shouldn't do that, especially people that support what I do. And this is a very vulnerable moment, and I shouldn't do this. But I'm just being real. You shouldn't fuck everybody that supports you. Like, you should not take that. You should let people be what they are and let them support you. And, that's it. I shouldn't, because it caused a lot of heartache on both ends, and it changed relationships with people that I had that I had real love for, as far as, like, I fucked with what they do, and now it's kind of weird. You know what I'm saying? So keep your dick in your pants. Stop lying. Don't lie, especially to the people that care about you. And nigga, just keep it a buck. And I think now I'm just getting older, nigga. That pussy shit, I'm done with it. I'm done with lying. Pussy make me lie. That's why I gotta stop fucking with it.
So that's the lesson.
I don't want no dick.
That's what you
but
learned.
I'm just saying, I don't want y'all to think I'm like fucking the game up switching. I'm going to chill because I need to discipline myself, because when it comes to pussy, I need a better control over, and I had a good control over, and I got a good control over now. I'm older. I'm 37 years old, about to be 38. Pussy shouldn't be something that drops me to my knees. No pun intended.
Okay.
What you learn, nigga?
Oh, lesson like of the year?
Boy,
okay.
I need to hit the water.
All right, so lesson of the year from the podcast. Man, it was – okay, let me go through the list, because it was so many different things, especially like – you know, because we get on some serious topics as much as we'll joke and everything like that.
For sure.
I think that, you know, I think that even like Nate gave some different perspective when we did the whole Jeezy and Love and the Jenny May, and kind of along the lines of what you're talking about, like just how men look at things and different, you know, different than women. But one of the biggest lessons that we were learning was the perspective of when Jason Jamerson and Jay Bell came on the show. We were talking about the whole D-Lay, Billy Sorrell situation, the comedians, and just the relationship that a wife can have with a male friend and a best friend. And just from the outside looking in, it's like, that seems like I would have my guard up on things, but from what Jay Bell and Jason kind of said, they said, like, you know, basically in that marriage, sometimes your wife's male best friend can be an advocate to keep that couple together and actually be fighting on your behalf. So from like my understanding from the outside, not being married and knowing just the angles of my mind, maybe thinking on a lower level or whatever, you know, sometimes husbands support and encourage that male friend outside the marriage,
so that men and women can be platonic friends. Because I definitely don't think that, because, like, you know what I'm saying, I've had every woman I've ever dealt with had friends that she thought was platonic, but they was really niggas just waiting in the background, like, I'm just waiting on my turn to get through. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of niggas don't have not game or just, you know, what it takes to be like what they want. A lot of niggas' superpower is persistence and patience. And they sit back in the cut and wait. And, you know, they be like, I can live in a friend zone because eventually I'll be able to put my head between those thighs.
I think it's my perspective from that episode was them as married men talking about it. Even though they may recognize that, they also recognize the whole concept of, you know, sometimes your wife needs another man to bounce some shit off of.
So that's what we're learning here. Men and women can be platonic friends, but it's also good, women, for you to know, like, just like you would tell us, it's a bitch want to fuck your guy. Like, she wants to fuck you. She's this, that, and third. Listen to your man, because I've used this analogy before, and Denzel said it in Training Day. You need a wolf to catch a wolf. All men have that shit inside of them. All men want to fuck you while you sleep. And now that you know that, understand that when your man tell you something, it ain't, a lot of times it's not insecurity. A lot of times it's just me letting you know that, hey, watch out for cuz, because cuz is really just sniffing around because he's just trying to find his way. And I stump a crease in that nigga pants if I got to, if he played with you wrong. So that's just what we want to let you know. All right, so what's the next cat?
All right, so the last one is
prettiest nipples.
Hilarious. It's the MVP. So guest of the year. That's it.
MVP, guest of the year. Now, this is hard because we had a lot of people on here, and I don't know where the year started, where the year began. Guest of the year, guest of the year, guest of the year. We had so many great podcasts. We had so many great guests on this podcast that it's hard for me to say that, man. Honestly, everybody is the MVP, and I know that's corny to say.
We had, I like the that we had the doctor that got the gorilla glue out of old girl's hair.
Are you talking about classic? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. That was very classic. That was very that was very MVP-ish. That was very doctor, whatever his name was, got all the way off and told us how. I think he said it was monkey pee. I think he said it was monkey pee. We had a lot of great guests on here though, but I mean, that might be it. Just to be like, all right, yeah, ended on that. MVP. Who we had here that was just really good? I mean, Lovie was great. I mean, I would hate to give her rookie and MVP, but she was great on this podcast. The MVP would be the couple from the live podcast, because they came on here and as a tandem, they put it all on the motherfucking line. Like,
yeah, like you said, that is like that. That is like the you. That's like damn Alabama, near. Nigga. It's Alabama. It's basically like you're going. Yeah,
they go pro. Everybody came out that podcast was the greatest podcast guest of any podcast that you've ever heard or seen on any TV show, talk show, news. They came and showed their ass. Everybody contributed. And it might just be that whole show. And I hate to give that show so much love because it caused so much turmoil in my life. I got to stop saying that. I did that. That podcast was still great. I went ahead and fucked people that I had no business fucking. So I can't blame the podcast. It was me. But what I will say is that couple was off the chain because my man said he didn't have no problem with another man fucking his girl, and he would tell him how to fuck his girl good.
Yeah.
He's the real MVP. For you to be able to tell a nigga to say, hey, man, when you hit my girl missionary, put one of them toes in your mouth, because that's what she like. You more than a man than I am, my nigga, because you better not never let a nigga hit that pussy when you engaged and in dealing with a nigga like me. So that is the MVP, in my opinion. That couple is the MVP together as one. And if they still together, shout out to them, but I don't think they are. But if they is, they MVP together and separate. So we got co-MVPs like when Grant Hill and Jason Kidd won. Co-MVP go to them. Shout out to them from the first live house pod. They showed their ass. Rap Talk got whatever he got for that night. But nigga, the MVPs, they were great. That whole podcast, that whole night was great. That whole weekend was amazing. So I'm going to give it to the whole first house pod. Those are the MVP guests because they showed up, showed out. We packed people in. We drunk. We had a good time. Shout out to Alicia who brought out all the food. She brought the games. She was amazing. Nigga, shout out to Khary for nigga just executing and putting shit together crazy. But let's go ahead and knock this out. What else we got going on here before right. we end
before
this
we wrap up
this
all right.
year?
So like I said, the song of today.
You gonna play it too?
Yeah, I'm gonna play a little. I'm gonna play the snippet. You know what I'm saying?
Song of the day, man.
As we know, and you're very familiar with this. This actually
but
may
set
end
it up
being
why it is the song of the
okay,
song of the
this
thing.
Is the song of the day.
Something. What did I say?
This basically this is my whole vibe of everything you've been saying this whole podcast about how you're feeling, your perspectives on engaging the fairer sex, which we explore often on this
podcast.
Better
not be no sugar free shit, bro.
No, it's not, brother.
Coming down with you,
No. I listen to a lot of sugar free, and he knows that. But no, it's this. This nigga.
Whoever can name this, get free tickets to a show I got coming up.
Your lips said hello, and I said hi. I knew I knew you were the one. And I was caught up in physical attraction, but to my satisfaction, maybe you were more than just afraid. And if I am in love, I will be sure that the lady is good.
Boy, so yes, that seems friend. To be. So let's go through the let's have you do the lyric breakdown.
Man, we're gonna break these lyrics down. I don't know what this got to do with me fucking with white girls in 2022. All right, here, man. Y'all didn't respond fast enough. That's Shy. With the song If I Ever Fall in Love Again. The lyrics start off, the very first time that I saw your brown eyes, your lips said hello. And of course, what he said, hi. I knew right then you were the one. That's a little presumptuous. Just because she said hello, you said hi, you like, this the bitch right here. You easily gonna get hurt if all a girl got to say to you is hello and you say hi for you to be like, this the one. But he ain't no fool because he said, I knew right then you were the one, but I was caught up in physical attraction, which a lot of us are. Physically, depending on where you at, as far as inebriation status wise, you'll put up with a lot of shit you wouldn't do. You looking at her, fat ass, big titties, beautiful smile. Hey man, she said hello, I said hi, she the one. You know what I'm saying? But to my satisfaction, what he said was, baby, you were more than just a phase. I didn't know that. I saw he said it. I thought he said you were more than just a friend. So I'm today years old when I found out that he said that you were more than just a phase. Now, we all deal with phases before where you like, I like light-skinned girls, or I like girls with fat asses. I like this, that, and the third. That's a phase. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And if I ever, ever fall in love again, I'll be sure that that lady is just a friend. I will be sure that that lady is just like you. Now, that sounds a little bit like Usher when he said that, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? The thing about you, he said, girl, the thing about you that caught my eye is the same thing that makes me change my mind. You remind me of a bitch who burnt me before. Figuratively and maybe even literally. But my thing is this, dog. You know what I'm saying? He wanted to find a girl that was just like this girl. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. The very next time, she will be my friend. And if I could be your one and only, promise, 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 promise. That nigga gonna get hurt. He wanted too bad. He promised too many times. He said, promise, 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 promise that you'll never leave me lonely. I just want to be what you need. Man, listen. If you like her more than she like you, it ain't gonna never work.
Wow.
If you like her more than she like you, it ain't gonna never work in your favor, my nigga. I'm telling you, bro. I've been in relationships where she like me more, and then I start showing more love, and then the relationship fell apart. She got to always feel like, nigga. She can't never put it like this. In the world of jobs, she can't never really take all the shit out of her box and organize her cubicle, because she got to feel like at any point in time I can be fired. She can't never let her get too comfortable, man. If a woman get comfortable, she gonna move on to the next nigga who gonna make her feel super uncomfortable. Women live in discomfort. If you make them feel comfortable, like, oh, I got this nigga pegged and I know what he wanted and this, that, and the third, you're gonna lose, my nigga.
Got on pegs.
Once she figure out she know what you're gonna do, she can't never know what you come to the table with. You can't never like or love her more than she like you or show her. So let me see here. The very next time she'll be my friend, someone who I can believe in. Very next time she'll be my friend, woody woo woo woo. And that's pretty much the gist of that song.
But I was thinking, just the way you're talking, it's like you looking for more of a stronger connection, more than physical.
I've never been a friend. Have you ever befriended a woman and then it turned into something?
Nah, not really.
That's what I'm saying. Like, me and you sit here and talk about, you know, we on different ends of the spectrum. I get into a lot of relationships and they don't work because of me. I'm gonna say that because motherfuckers be like, you never take accountability because of me. Khary, you don't get in relationships, you don't, because you jump straight into like, man, this is what I want from you. I don't need to be a friend because this is where you fit in my life. Now, if you were to befriend somebody, you'll find that, oh, she can contribute to situations in your life and what you're doing more. And if I was to befriend and build with somebody more, I would be able to enhance all the other shit that when I want to get into it. So I think that actually building a real bond with a motherfucker could possibly, you know what I'm saying, increase a better outcome.
We know a topic to, because the friendship opens up to vulnerability of my mind, like I always say, my program, because the premise of the connection is
you'll stop calling it a program.
It's a friend. The friendship is a different get down. So like, that's a different amount of vulnerability that I'm not used to. So I would be uncomfortable coming from that angle, but that would be new. That would be new for me. That'd be new for you.
Yeah, it is. So 2022 is discipline and celibacy. And we hard on these hoes. Everybody should go with that mantra into the new year, man. Be hard on a hoe. And a hoe could be anybody. It could be a woman. It could be a man. It could be a manager. It could be COVID. It could be your goals, but be hard on a hoe. All 22, you've been taking it too easy on these hoes. Hard on a bitch. That could be a man, it could be a woman, it could be a dog, it could be a cat. It could be whatever you're dealing with. You got cancer, be hard on that motherfucker. That's what we doing in 22. We going hard on everything we got going on. You know what I'm saying? I don't know how I made that work, but I did. I took a pimp turn, and I made it something everybody can take and use in their life. So the hoe could be the devil. Whatever your thing is, be hard on a hoe in 22. Put your tools up. We being hard on a hoe. You know what I'm saying? 22, I don't know what it is. I don't study numerology, but we're going to be four times harder on these hoes than we was in 21. Hilarious. Khary is with it. And if a nigga fuck you while he sleep, it's because he got real love for you. Because he know you on a level that nobody else know you on. So if you wake up with some dick in you, don't look up and be like, this nigga is a weirdo. Be like, you know what? This nigga cared enough about my satisfaction to fuck me before I even knew I needed to be satisfied. So, hey, man, we got some big things coming up, man. We building this brick by brick, man. Shout out to Christina. Shout out to Riri. Shout out to Dave Jizzle.
Riri on it. She said that's what she y'all. Josh is saying some dumb shit.
Flat out, Riri. We hard on hoes. That's your career. That's these niggas. Politicians. Like, nigga, if whoever you, nigga, your alderman, your president, alderman. Nigga, your government, your governor, nigga, gubernatorials, your landlord. Hey, man, if your motherfucking heat ain't working, we hard on the hoe this year. Hey, nigga, you need this rent, nigga? I need you to go ahead and fix this motherfucking nigga. This fan in here, I should cut this fan on. It should suck all the stank out my house. We hard on the hoe all 22.
Hilarious.
Hey, man, we want more from the people around us because we giving more. We giving more, so we want more. I want as much as I give out. I'm giving out 110%, nigga. I need 125 bite. Because we hard on the hoe, all 22.
Hilarious.
Flat out. So listen, man. I told you everything I got going on. I ain't going to promote nothing else, but I want everybody to stay safe. COVID is out here and it's real. For it seems, ain't no same as real. Stay safe. Make sure you're intentional about how you move, man. If you ain't got to go nowhere, don't go nowhere. Stay spaced out. Keep your mask on. February the 11th, we got something special planned, man. Something for the singles. All the people that want, everybody that's trying to be hard on these hoes on 22, I need y'all to come through. Everybody that want to be Fred Flintstone on a hoe in 22.
Fred Flintstone.
Bedrock shit. Everybody on their Barney Rubble in 22. Everybody on their Wilma in 22. February the 11th. Mark your calendar. There's five people here. Mark your calendar. We got an event plan that I think is going to be really big fun. And regardless of what's finna happen, whether they shut shit down or whatever it is, it's going to be set up enough to where everybody going to be safe and we're going to have a good time. We're going to have a great ass time. So all the singles, weekend of Valentine's Day, February the 11th. Mm-hmm. We just going to say the date. We ain't going to get a venue out. Astro Bay, what's happening? I need my cookies and I got your hoodie. We going hard on hoes, all 22. For the people that's new to this shit.
This is goofy.
We hard on hoes. Oh shit, not single. Nicholas, that's crazy. You know why? You ain't got to be single to come to this. You know what I'm saying? This for everybody. I can't get a location out, but mark your calendars. Yeah. February the 11th. It's in the city of Detroit, though. I want everybody to know that because I know we got people out to the city and everywhere else. February the 11th in the city, downtownish. Mm-hmm. We got some shit popping off. Big fun. It's going to be a very, very fun event. And I know I'm calling all the singles out, but it's more of a it's more how you relate to Valentine's Day, more than being single. So you can even be somebody in a whole happy relationship and come out. So don't think if you come out with your girl or your guy that somebody going to be sniping. No, it's just about your relationship with Valentine's Day. So anybody that's in a situation where you might not be all the way in love with love right now, you can come out. You're going to have a good time. We're going to have some good, wholesome fun. And you can come be hard on a hoe. 2022, February the 11th. Everybody, mark your calendars right now. If you mark your calendars right now, I need everybody who just marked their calendars. I need a green check in the comments. It's five people in here. I need five green checks before we go.
Hilarious.
I need five green checks in the comments right now. If you marked in your calendars, February the 11th. I need green checks. Okay,
they
good.
Just went there.
Hold on. Okay, good. The girl last night drops. She's down for bringing in other people in the bedroom. And you know what you are? You already being blessed coming into 22. But Nick, I need you to let her know. I'm hard on hoes.
Don't say no goofy shit like that, Nick.
Hey, if you mark your calendar, I'm waiting. Before I need five people. I need five checks in there right now to know people that mark their calendars for February the 11th. We have an event planned. It's going to be safe. It's going to be fun. And you have never come through and experienced anything like this before. February the 11th, hosted by me. It's going to be a great time. I need y'all to check it out. It's in the city of Detroit. Great parking. Great venue. Big fun. Mm-hmm. February, Valentine's Day weekend, man. It's about your relationship with Valentine's Day, man. Ooh, I see one. What I see here? Ha ha ha. Fucking marked February the 11th. Katrina just marked it. Ooh, Astro Bay, I need my cookie. I got your hoodie. We getting it popping. I see one, two, three, four. I need one more. I see one more. And I think we good, unless this is somebody who's spamming. He, like, they do some type of you know how motherfuckers be spamming and shit like that. Like, man, I can take 500, turn to 1500. Or you want me to draw you a cartoon? All right, everybody,
that's
mark their calendars.
Story.
So I'm going to keep these people names in mind. And y'all go get discounts on the advanced tickets that we popping up with, man. Mm-hmm. But it's going down. So I'm glad to know y'all tapped in. So February 11th, we're going to have more information as we go along. But listen, man, I wish nothing but blessings to everybody on these on the new year coming up. Please be safe. Mm-hmm. Y'all made it. We made it already. The next year, man, hey, man, it's a clean slate. You get to do it. Everyone, every day is a clean slate. But, hey, a new year is coming upon us. Anything you want, you can have it, man. You just got to manifest it. All right, what you got going on, Car?
Man, same old, same old. We're going to be doing more stuff, more guests. We probably going to take this on the road. We're going to travel a little bit with this. Have some fun. You'll get more in the podcast. We're going to put more into the YouTube of it. EJ definitely holding us down. So if you're watching now, just keep watching. And then don't be surprised if we Wednesday nights now. Don't be surprised if we pop in maybe on a Monday or a Friday, or we may add a night. Probably going to add a night.
We're going to add some shit. You never know, man. Hey, thank y'all for tapping in. Happy New Year's for the people, man. If I don't see you before then, like I said, Ann Arbor Showcase, I'm going to see y'all tomorrow, man. Happy New Year's, man. And with everything in my heart and soul, I mean this, dog. I love y'all. Real talk, man. Be cool, man. Y'all be easy out there. 100. Man, I fucked up. I shouldn't even need all this mayhem, bro, but it's gone. We did it. We ain't taking nothing in the future, nigga. We leaving all that bullshit in the past. We hard on these hoes. All 22. We hard on these hoes.
Don't be paying no attention to this craziness.